starting to queue up over there, I think.
Okay, yep. Here's the...
Okay, here we go, everybody.
And here we go. Here we go.
We're going to have us a celebration today.
Thank you.
Gather round, everybody, for the celebration of love. Who gives this woman to marry this man?
I do.
We do.
Bill, as father of Pamela, do you give your blessing for this marriage?
Indeed, I do.
Grace, as mother of Pamela, do you give your blessing for this marriage?
I do.
Please, have a seat, sir.
Where?
Take a breath, my lovely woman. Here we go. Welcome, one and all. And how beautiful is this day that has been touched by love? To shout, can I hear a love? And everybody says love. Can I hear a love?
Love!
That's correct. Now, having a commitment to each other is a very special and spiritual connection of two people united in a common purpose, bringing love and trust together in a single focus. Can I hear love?
Love!
Into this union, Pamela and Danny now come and be joined. If any of you have just cause why these two lovely people should not be joined today, I suggest you keep it to yourself. Excuse me.
I got something to say.
Tommy got something to say.
Pam, it's your last chance, honey.
I'm all in.
Run.
Well, I'm going to say one thing. I got a little quote I got from a doctor. I'm going to pitch you guys. I want to save it for you.
Dig it up, Tom.
Okay, we're all a little weird. Life is a little weird. We find someone whose weirdness is compatible with our own, we join in mutual weirdness. And it's called love. So, Dan, you're about the weirdest guy I know. I hope the mutual weirdness goes on.
I want to thank Tommy for clearly stating what needed to be said. If you find that weird person that makes your weird looks normal, take that person by the hand. Now we begin to know that love is here and now, real and true, the most important things in life. For love is the creator of our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Without love, we merely exist. With love, we truly begin to live. Say love.
Love!
Big love.
Big love. Big love.
Now, Pam and Dan want this day to be special for everybody in attendance. For those of you who are committed to each other, you might want right now to silently renew and reaffirm your vows by joining hands through this ceremony. And if you're here and you just want to feel the love and aura and energy that love brings, hold somebody's hand. You don't even have to know them. Just touch somebody's hand and feel the love that is about to happen here. Now, as we talk about love, let us also talk about partnership. Partnership is what it's all about. You can have a relationship, but not have a partner. If you have a partner, you have a relationship. You want a partner to be your best friend. Someone you can sleep with. Someone you can make love to. Someone to hustle with. That's right, you're hustling every day. You need that partner to hustle with you. Someone to live with. Now, you want your partner You want your partner to be a partner in love. Say love.
Love.
You want your partner to be a partner in crime. Say crime. And let's say love so we can crime. Yes. And then you want your partner to be your partner in life. Now, what can you do with your partner? What should you do with your partner?
Love.
Love is correct. Whoever said that. Here, five love. Boom. You can laugh with your partner. Because without laughter, there is no love. And without love, there is no laughter. You can build with your partner. Like you just open up a large Lego set, everything is awesome if you build with your partner. You can also trust your heart with your partner. You can trust your money with your partner. I don't know these two, but I know they trust each other. They trust each other with their lives because they are partners. Now when you find that special partner, you won't be afraid to lose them because you know they're always gonna be there to help you believe in the power of love. Let me hear you say love.
Love!
They will help you believe in what you can touch. They will help you believe in what you can taste. They'll help you believe in what you can feel and what you can see. And if you believe in what you can see, and if you see it, you can do it. When you believe it, there's nothing to it. You believe you can fly. You believe you can touch the sky. You believe you can fly. Oh, Pamela and Danny, I want to thank you very much for inviting me out to help celebrate this love. Now, Pamela and Danny, true marriage is the holiest of all earthly unions. It is to be entered into reverently, consciously, and with full understanding of its significance. Commitment only works when it is based upon a deep inner communion of two souls who find completion each in the other. Today, your separate lives will, each with individual memories, desires, and hopes, will merge together into one life, a new dimension. Happiness is not something that just happens. A great partnership must be created. In the art of commitment, the little things are the big things. If you're never too old to hold hands, say love.
Love!
Good love.
You have to remember to say I love you out loud at least once a day. Say
I love.
Love you! Love.
You should never go to sleep angry. You go to bed angry, just don't go to sleep angry. Forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. You're doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. Speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. Giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It's not only committing to the right partner, it's being the right partner. I'm gonna repeat that, because that's important. It's not committing to the right partner, it's being the right partner. Say love.
Love!
This commitment can be a great adventure, but it is an outward expression of great love. Such a love is characterized by passion, courage, and compassion. It allows you to see through your partner's essence, willing to be a total support for your partner's well-being, his goals, her purpose, each other's spirit, and unwilling for your partner to be less than he or she can be, spiritually, mentally, or physically. Such a love requires that you be totally honest with yourself and your mate. That you ask for what you want. Take action, even though you are afraid. Share your feelings and listen, but leave your partner free to be who they really are. In other words, always love your partner for who they are, not for who you think they should be. Again, I'm going to repeat that. Always love your partner for who they are, not who you think they should be. Say love. Always remember, relationships are something that you must work on all the time. Not just when they're broken and need to be fixed. Never stop doing what brought the two of you together in the first place. We
love.
Feel like saying love without me typing to you. You go ahead. You do that. It's your day, sweetheart. As your friends and family gathered here today, except for you, a love that brings out your magnificence. A love that gives you courage to stand apart and the willingness to stand together. When time calls for you to be apart, you may always return to your togetherness in the same spirit of love that you are feeling right now. Say love!
Love!
Pam and Dan, will you release the past, bringing only those memories, desires, and hopes which you will belong to each other in the future life together? Please face each other. At this time, Pam and Dan would like to make their personal promises to one another. If she says you go first, you go first. Welcome to love!
Thank you for coming into my life. I so enjoy your company, your friendship, your humor, your tenderness, and your love. I speak for Willie, too. Honey, I vow to love you, hold you, and protect you to the day I die. Even though we will disagree, at the end of the day, I vow to respect, support, and stand by your decision. I vow to go ahead and let you mow the yard once a week.
Love!
And the same with snowballing in the winter. I vow to never forget how lucky I am that someone upstairs gave me the chance to be with you. I vow to cook once a month. Same with doing the dishes. I vow to never forget what a beautiful redhead Irish woman you are. Thanks for being my girl. Same for Will.
Hold on, folks. Woo! Your turn, man.
In my 30s, I made a list of...
Oh, the honey you
want?
You let it flow, girl. You let it flow.
Love.
It is flowing.
In my 30s, I made a list of what I wanted in a man. But I tore up that list when I met you. Because you exceed any want, need, or dream I've ever had. Aww. You make me laugh. You make me feel loved. You make me feel safe. You love me like no other. And I love you more than I ever thought was possible. Mostly, I love that you let me be me. You love me completely. And you don't even try to be the boss of me.
Love!
My God.
You are my best friend. And I will love you forever.
You let them kiss if they want a kiss.
Not yet.
That was written at 5:30 this morning.
5:34.
All right. Pamela and Dan. Pamela, do you reach out in love to receive Danny and choose to share your life with him? Will you promise always to give him your expression of your ever-growing love? Will you comfort him, Be sensitive to his needs. Express your feelings with him. Listen to him. Put your trust in him. And forsaking all others, be his intimate friend and honor him with your equal partnership.
I do?
Oh, yes. Danny, do you reach out in love to receive Pamela and choose to share your life with her? Will you promise always to give to her your expression of your ever-growing love? Will you comfort her? Be sensitive to her needs. Express your feelings with her. Listen to her. Put your trust in her. And forsaking all others, be her intimate friend and honor her as your equal partner.
I sure will.
We kiss a lot.
And that's the way it should be.
Love.
Love.
Say love again.
Love.
Danny, please repeat after me. In the name of love.
In the name of love.
Danny, choose you, Pamela.
I, Danny, choose you, Pamela.
To be my life partner.
To be my life partner.
My wife.
My wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and health.
To honor and respect.
To honor and respect.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
I say these words because I love you.
I say these words because I love you.
And choose to live the rest of my life with you.
And choose to live the rest of my life with you.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Love!
Love!
Pamela, please repeat after me. In the name of love.
In the name of love.
I, Pamela, choose you, Danny.
I, Pamela, choose you, Danny.
To be my life partner.
My husband,
to have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and poorer.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and health.
To honor and respect.
To honor and respect and not obey.
Not obey. No one said obey. To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
I say these words because I love you.
I say these
words. And choose to live the rest of my life with you.
And choose to live the rest of my life with you.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn
vow. Love!
Love!
These spoken commitments to each other are the alignment of your words, which speaks boldly of your intentions and your actions, which are louder than your words. What symbols do you give in this marriage?
Rings, right?
Yes. Good answer. Your rings are
chains.
Your rings are circles, and a circle is a symbol of the sun, earth, and universe, the wholeness, perfection, peace, and unity. Like circles, your rings have no beginning and no end. And in the sacred tradition of commitment rings, have come to symbolize eternal love and the endless union of body, mind, and spirit. These rings will be worn by Pamela and Danny to show to the world their love and commitment to one another. May the presence of these rings always remind you of the eternal love you have pledged and devotion you willingly share with one another. From this moment on, let each of us in his own way, may it be a prayer, may it be a thought, whatever you and I would wish for this couple, let's pray or have our thoughts as a blessing upon these rings. Let us pause at this time for a silent blessing over all of these rings. These rings, now blessed, are a symbol of love and faithfulness. They seal the vow of marriage and represent a promise of forever love. You just gotta fall from love, that's all.
Love from above.
Dad's got it, Dad's got it.
Honey.
Bye, getting married. Yeah.
Can I help you?
You ready, buddy? Here we go.
Lily.
Okay. This is the important part now. Annie, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the presence of love.
In the presence of love.
And our family and friends.
And our family and friends.
You may now place the ring on her finger. Everybody say love!
Love!
Pamela, please repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the presence of love and our family and friends. Pamela, please. You may put the ring on his finger. Everybody say love.
Yeah.
Woo. Now that Pamela and Danny have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I now pronounce you husband and wife partners. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Dan Fisher.